मिस्टर एस के कुलकर्णी, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस विथ यू ऑन टॉपिक सीव एनालिसिस ऑफ एग्रीगेट्स फॉर कॉन्क्रीट लर्निंग आउटकम्स। एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन सीव एनालिसिस ऑफ एग्रीगेट्स फॉर कॉन्क्रीट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट इज सीव एनालिसिस? Sieve analysis is the name given to the operation of dividing a sample of aggregate into various fractions, each consisting of particles of the same size. In photograph, you can see the number of sieves arranged in sequential order. These are standard sieves as per IS, Indian standard sieves. The sieve analysis is conducted to determine the particle size distribution in a sample of aggregate, which we call gradation. Okay, so sieve analysis is done and gradation of the aggregates is obtained. Let us see what are the sieve sizes. A convenient system of expressing the gradation of aggregates is one which the consecutive sieve openings are constantly doubled, such as 10 mm, 20 mm, 40 mm, and so on. Here you can see the sieves arranged in sequential order. Now, aggregate sizes. The aggregates used for making concrete are normally of the maximum size 80 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 600 micron, 300 micron, 150 micron. Now, the aggregate fraction from 80 mm to 4.75 mm, it is termed as coarse aggregate, and the fractions from 4.75 mm to 150 micron are termed as fine aggregates, that means sand. The size 4.75 mm is a common fraction appearing both in coarse and fine aggregates, remember. Now, what are the sieving methods? Grading pattern of sample of coarse aggregate and fine aggregate is assessed by sieving a sample successively through all the sieves mounted one over the other in order of size, with larger sieve on the top. Remember, larger sieve is kept on the top, and subsequent sieves are arranged in order. The material retained on each sieve after shaking represents the fraction of aggregate coarser than the sieve in question and finer than the sieve above. So, material retained on particular sieve will be coarser than that particular sieve and finer than the sieve above. Sieving can be done either manually or mechanically. So, you can do manually the sieving process, or mechanical equipments are available, mechanical sievers are available, which can be used for sieving purpose. Now, manual and mechanical methods. In the manual operation, the sieve is shaken, giving movements in all possible direction to give chance to all particles for passing through the sieve. Operation should be continued till such a time that almost no particle is passing through. So, generally 15 to 20 minutes are sufficient so that all the particles will pass through the sieve and remaining will retain on the sieve. Mechanical devices are actually designed to give motion in all possible direction, and as such it is more systematic and efficient than hand sieving. So, mechanical devices or sieve shakers which are used, those are more efficient. So, when small quantity is to be sieved, you can go with manual sieving. And if large quantity is there, then, or for coarse aggregate particularly, mechanical devices are must. Those must be used. For sand also, you can use mechanical devices. Now, the IS 2386 part 1, 1963, this code gives what should be the minimum weight of sample for sieve analysis. So, according to the size of the particles, minimum weight to be taken for sieving is decided. So, for example, for see, here are maximum size present in the substantial proportions. So if suppose your aggregates are having 63 mm as the maximum size in your coarse aggregate group, then you can or you should go with 50 kg of sample for sieving. If 50 mm is the maximum size, then you can go with 35 kg of sample size. 40 mm if is the maximum size, or 31.5 mm, then you can go for 15 kg of sample size. If 25 mm is the maximum size of your coarse aggregate, 5 kg of sample is sufficient. For 20 or 16 mm, 2 kg of sample is sufficient. For 12.5 mm maximum size, 1 kg is sufficient. For 10 mm maximum size, 0.5 kg is sufficient. For 6.3 mm maximum size, 0.2 kg is sufficient. For 4.75 mm, 0.2 kg is sufficient. And for 2.36, 0.1 kg is sufficient. So these guidelines should be followed while taking sample for sieve analysis. Now let us see what is fineness modulus, very important term. From the sieve analysis, the particle size distribution in a sample of aggregate is found out. In this connection, a term fineness modulus, FM, is being used. What is this fineness modulus? Fineness modulus is a ready index of coarseness or fineness of the material. So, fineness modulus is an empirical factor obtained by adding the cumulative percentages of aggregate retained on each of the standard sieves ranging from 80 mm to 150 micron and dividing this sum by an arbitrary number 100. So, how this fineness modulus is obtained? Fineness modulus is obtained by taking summation of cumulative percentages of aggregates retained on each of the standard sieves ranging from 80 mm to 150 micron. And then this sum is divided by 100. So this will give us fineness modulus of that particular aggregate. And remember, this is an empirical factor. This is an empirical factor. So fineness modulus will give an idea about coarseness or fineness of the material in particular aggregate group. Now, what is the significance of this fineness modulus? The larger the figure, that means larger the fineness modulus, the coarser is the material, remember. So, larger the fineness modulus, you will find that the material is coarser in the particular aggregate group. Are designed or many times fine aggregates are designated as coarse sand, medium sand and fine sand. Now these classifications do not give any precise meaning. What the supplier terms as fine sand may be really medium or even coarse sand. So how to decide exactly whether it is a fine, medium or even? Or to avoid this ambiguity, fineness modulus could be used as a yardstick to indicate the fineness of sand. So here fineness modulus comes to help. We can bifurcate, we can distinguish between fine sand, coarse sand and medium sand. Now what are those limitations? Which sand can be called as fine sand? So according to IS, fine sand will be that sand whose fineness modulus ranges between 2.2 to 2.6. Remember. Medium sand will be that sand whose fineness modulus will range between 2.6 to 2.9. Coarse sand will be that particular sand whose fineness modulus will range between 2.9 to 3.2. And remember, a sand having fineness modulus more than 3.2 will be unsuitable for making satisfactory concrete. So sand whose fineness modulus is more than 3.2 should not be used in making of concrete, remember. So here is a typical example of sieve analysis sheet. So in this particular sheet, we can see sieve sizes are given on the left hand side. 80 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm, 10 mm, 4.75 mm, 2.36 mm, 1.18 mm, 600 micron, 300, 150 micron, and lower than 150 micron in total. Now, for coarse aggregate and for fine aggregate, same are the columns. So, for example, for coarse aggregate, we can see weight retained in kg. So, weight retained in particular on particular sieve is recorded here. Then, cumulative weight retained is found out. Cumulative percentage retained is found out. So, cumulative of all percentage weight retained is found out. Its total is taken. And this total divided by 100 gives fineness modulus, remember. So, the fineness modulus is found in such a fashion. Then, cumulative percentage passing is also recorded. Same values, similar values are recorded for fine aggregate also. And fineness modulus of sand is also found in the similar fashion. So, let us stop a while, students, here. Here are few review questions for you. Answer these questions. So, answer to question number 1. Fineness modulus ranging from 2.2 to 2.6 represents fine sand. Answer is A, fine sand. Now, second one. A sand having a fineness modulus more than dash dash will be unsuitable for making satisfactory concrete. So, C, 3.2 is the correct answer. So, these are the answers. Hope you have written the correct answers. These are the references for today's session. Thank you.